We want to calculate the area of the portion of plane x over a plus y over b plus z over c equal to 1 contained in the first octant. So if we want to calculate an area, we need to calculate a surface integral. So I will call the area or the surface S. And we have to integrate using the usual formula, the determinant of the position vector x, which depends on two parameters. These two parameters can be u and v, for example, or in this case, we can just call them x and y. So I take the derivative of x with respect to x, and then I have to take the cross product between this vector and another vector, dx over dy, and integrate over dx dy. This determinant here is actually the magnitude of the determinant, so we need to consider the magnitude of this vector. And if we want to calculate the determinant, in the first row, I will put the three unit vectors I, j, k. And then in the second row, I have to take the derivative of this position vector with respect to x, which is 1, because the three components of this vector are just simply x, y, z, and z is just f of x, y. And how can I find z or f of x, y? Well, I just simply have to obtain it from this equation, because that's the equation of the plane, the equation of the area that we want to find. So we have 1, and then here I have the derivative of y with respect to x, which is 0 because x and y are independent, and then here we have df over dx. Whereas in the third row, I have 0, 1, df over dy. And if I take this determinant, I will get a vector whose first component is minus df over dx, and then I will have minus df over dy, and then I will just have 1. So if I consider the magnitude of this vector and I put it inside this integral, I will get that this is equal to integral square root of 1 plus df over dx squared plus df over dy squared, and then I have to integrate over dx dy. Now, if I substitute the expression above, let me circle it in red here. So instead of z here, I can just consider f of xy, and then I have to take the derivative of f of xy with respect to x and also with respect to y, and I have to substitute it into this integral, and this will give me the following. So I have integral of dx dy, and then I have the square root of 1 plus c over a squared, so this is related to the derivative of f with respect to x from that equation there, and then I also have to square it, so I don't need any sign because I'm just squaring that formula. So let me do it just once. From here you get z equal to c times 1 minus x over a minus y over b. So if I take the derivative of z, or if you want f, with respect to x, it is just equal to minus c over a. And that's why it appears there. I don't need to put a minus sign because it's squared. And then I have plus c over b squared. And now I have to integrate that. And I have to integrate over x and over y. So I have to look at my plane from above. So if this is the x-axis, this is the y-axis. And here I have to set z equal to 0 because I'm integrating on the xy plane. And I can set z equal to 0 here, and therefore I will get the equation y equal to b times 1 minus x over a from here, which is something like this. It is a line, and the x coordinate of this point is just equal to a, whereas the y coordinate of this point is just equal to b. It's very easy to realize from this equation here. So my integral in here will become, let me do it below here, it will just be equal to this constant, square root of 1 plus c over a squared plus c over b squared, and then I have to integrate. It's a double integral in this case. I have to integrate first over y, for example. So if I integrate over y here, I have to integrate from 0 to the equation of this line. So 0 here, and then here I have b times 1 minus x over a. And then I have to integrate from here, which is still equal to 0, and then I have to go all the way up to x equal to a. So from 0 to a here, and dx. The second integration is performed over dx. So this is a simple integral. Let me do it. I have this same factor, square root of 1 plus c over a squared plus c over b squared. And then I have to integrate this. So integral from 0 to a of b times 1 minus x over a dx. And this integral will give me b times a minus b a over 2 from this one. Because when I integrate x, I get x squared over 2. And when I evaluate it at the boundary, I will get this term here. So this will give me b a over 2. And I can rewrite the result like this. So I have 1 half, and then I can put b a inside the square root there, so I have to square both b and a, so I get square root of b squared a squared plus b squared c squared plus a squared c squared. And this is the result of our integral, namely the area of the plane.